Good morning everyone, I'm Damien George and today I will guide you through a full example of species distribution modeling using BioMod 2. I would like to highlight that most of what you will see today is highly inspired by habitat suitability and distribution model with application in R, which is a good book if you want to go further with SDM and BioMod 2. If you want to understand what is going on today, I encourage you to watch the video of Introduction to BioMod 2 by Wilfried Toulier. It's also good if you are somehow familiar with R and if you have some basics of the raster package. The goal of this tutorial is to model the species distribution of the Protea lorifolia, an endemic species of South Africa, against some world-class predictors. Here are listed all the steps we are going through today, from getting the data, installing BioMod 2, and read and format the data in a BioMod 2 friendly way, define model option, running individual then ensemble models, and at the end of this tutorial we will produce some maps of projection and have a look at them. Let's start by getting the data. All the data you need to complete this tutorial are available on GitHub in the BioMod Hub team repository on BioMod 2 tutorial material. If you click here you will see a zip file, video single species modeling. Just have to click here and on download. When it's downloaded on your computer, just extract it on your PC. You should now have a directory called BioMod 2 video single species modeling, and in this directory you should have a data directory with our species occurrency as a CSV and some world clean predictor we will use in our model. There is also a directory called script where you can find the R script I will run today. We are now going to get BioMod 2 and set up the workspace. I have opened the script and the first thing I want to do is to set the right working directory here, workdir. Then I want to install the latest release of BioMod 2 package available on GitHub with install underscore GitHub function. Once it's done, you can double check that it's well done loading the package. If you get something saying BioMod 2 loaded, you are done. We will also use some extra packages, so just try to load them, and if you have some error at some point, install them from cron with install.packages function. Here we are, so let's now read the data. Just to help you to follow where I am, I can open this little summary that will show you where we are at any time of the practical. Species occurrences are stored in a CSV, so let's read it and have a look how it likes. So we see that it's a 3-column data frame with the longitude, latitude and the species occurrences. We can see here that there is only once, means that we are working with presence only data. We can then load our bioclimatic data stored as map with stack from raster package. Here we are going to work with three variables, the three first that are related to temperature and the latest one is related to precipitations. Let's have a quick look to this raster stack. Everything seems okay. It is important to keep in mind that your species occurrences from your data frame has to be in the same system of coordinates than your raster files. The following step is to format the data in a BioMod 2 friendly. To do so, we will use BioMod formatting data, which requires species occurrences and associated coordinates and the explanatory variables. We will also have to define, because we have presence only data, some pseudo absences. Here we generate 500 randomly selected pseudo absences 2 times. I will not go into the details, but if you want more information about pseudo absences selection and their impact, I advise you to watch my Maya Guéguen video. We can double check that the data are well written and look at the plot. So here we can see the green area are where the species is present and the red are where pseudo absences have been selected. The gray area is the background. Let's have a look to the model options. In BioMod 2, every single model can be tuned with a set of parameters. The choice of this parameter can influence your model performance. In this tutorial, we will just use a simple set of parameters, making a quadratic GLM, using a thousand of trees for the GBM algorithm, and using MGCV package to produce our gamma. Let's now compute our models. Running several models with the same input data can be easily done in BioMod 2 with BioMod modeling function. You have to give the input data, the selection of model you want to run among the 10 variables, the options. You can then specify some cross-validation settings. Here, 80% of the data for calibration, 20 for the evaluation of the models. And in this example, I decided also to run the variable importances procedure 3 times. I run it, but that can take a while. The modeling procedure has succeeded. We can now have a look to our model's qualities. Model's evaluation score can be accessed with getEvaluation function. You get a complex array. For each evaluation score, model type, cross-validation run or pseudo-absences dataset, you can get the model performance score. This score is associated with a cutoff that will give you a defined specificity and specificity of detection of your species. As you can see here, there is a full, which means that's the model that have been computed and evaluated against 100% of the data. You have to be conscious that this model can sometimes overfit the data. A good way to investigate a model evaluation score is through plots. Model score graph function can help you to do that. The key parameters is the by that will help you to select the stratification, the strata you want to use to plot the model. For instance, here we want to see if the choice of the model changed the evaluation score. This graph gives you by algorithm the ROC, the average ROC and TSS score of the model. More you are close to the upper corner, better you are. Here we can see that random forest seems to perform slightly better than other models. You can do exactly the same, but splitting by cross-validation run. Here we see that the model that is computed with all the data is slightly better than the other one, but not that much better. And you can also split the evaluation by the pseudo-absences dataset. And here we see that there is almost no difference between the two pseudo-absences dataset, which is good. Here we want to investigate the importance of variable per algorithm. So we will use this apply function to get the mean variable importance per algorithm. Closer to one a score is, most important is a variable. Here we clearly see that Bio19, which is based on precipitation, is the most important in all the models. The three other variables seems to be less important in this model. Let's now have a look to the evaluation strip plot. To do so, you will first have to load your models into your workspace with BioMod Load Models for the GLM, GBM, Random Forest and GAM. Then you can use ResponsePlot2 function giving these just loaded models. All the other features are to given the data, the same input data and the variable we want to select it. For instance, we can see that our model predict a kind of narrow range of temperature annual range where the species can develop, and the same with the precipitation of the coldest months. Then you can do exactly the same for your GBM, random forest and GAM. Okay. So now we are quite happy with our individual models. We can build the ensemble models. This is one of the key features of BioMod 2. You can put all the individual models together with ensemble modeling function. You have to give the modeling output, and then you can define how you want to ensemble the model. So we want to ensemble all the models. You can give a selection threshold. So we want to keep only the models that have a TSS score upper to 0.8. We also want to evaluate our model with the TSS and ROC scores. Then we have to give the type of algorithm we want to run. So for instance, here the coefficient of variation that would give you an idea of the variabilities among models, the committee averaging, which is a voting algorithm, and the probability weighting mean. So let's run this command one more time, that can take a while. When it's done, you can have a look to the evaluation score of your ensemble. You would get the same type of outputs than individual models' evaluations. Here you see that you have NAs for the coefficient of variation because there is no sense to evaluate this model quality. Here we can see that our models perform very well because we have scores really close to 1 for the TSS and the ROC scores. All the models and individual models have been built, so now we can do the projections. You can project your individual models with biomod projections and your ensemble models with biomod ensemble forecasting. Both functions get the same types of input. You have to give the modeling objects the environment, so here the same than the one we use to build the models, then a projection name, and you can additionally produce binary maps according to a score, here the TSS. So let's run this two commands, which will take a while, up, and we come back in 1 minute. So individual and ensemble models projection have been computed, and all the results have been stored on your hard drive. So let's have a look to that. So if you go in your working directory, you can see that there is a Protealory Fourier folder. And you also have something called Proj Current. And if you go there, you have all the single projection of the models as raster files. File names should be explicit enough to let you know exactly which model that have been run. For instance, the first pseudo absences, the second cross-validation run for the GLM, for the binary output by the TSS, and so on and so on. So we are done with the current environmental condition, but we can want to do the same with the future condition. So let's just load the climatic condition in 2050 and run the two same function, just changing the environmental variable. And we can do exactly the same for the 2070 environmental condition. You can easily see what's your projection look like with the plot function. So for instance, here we select only the committee averaging and the weighted mean for 2070. The two ensemble models are giving really similar projections, and you have to divide by 1000 to switch back to a probability scale. So we are almost there, and now we are going to look at how our species will change range in the future condition, and we will have also a look to how the probabilities are influenced according to different strata. Species range change requires binary data to be run. It is a one-to-one comparison. In this example, we will compare current projections to the one in the future in 2050 and 2070. We will do this comparison for committee averaging and weighted mean and some models. So let's load the current and the future projection for on some models. We can now compute the SRC with biomod range size function. So for instance, here the difference between current and 2050 condition. Biomod's range size will produce the outputs as a data frame in the comp by model. Here you will have access to the number of pixel loss or gain by the species. You have also access to the number of pixels where the species is not neither in the current and the future condition, and the one where the species is and will remain in the future conditions. You have then access on the percentage of loss and gain and the species range change, which is the differential of both. So here we see that in average our species will lost 47% of its habitat in 2050. The exact same procedure can be done comparing current and 2070 condition. And we can see that the species will keep losing area. Biomod range size produces also a map version of these outputs in div by pixel item. So here we will just load them and give them like readable, human readable names, and we can visualize them with raster vis level plot function. So if we zoom on that, here area where the species will maintain are in light green, and we can see that a big part of the current range will be lost. That's the reddish. The last step of this journey will be to investigate a bit deeper how the choice of the model, the pseudo-absences dataset, or the cross-validation run can influence the species range distribution. To do so, we will consider that the current projection for the committee averaging is the most accurate representation of the species distribution we have for now. We will compare it with the projection of our individual models in 2070. So I start by defining my strata, so my modeling strata, my pseudoabsences selection strata, and my cross-validation type strata. The next step is to produce all the possible combination of this stratification, and then to select like the projection in 2070 that match this stratification with this function. Here I remove the unwanted projections. And finally, I can investigate how our stratifications influence the SRC distribution with prop dense function. So that takes a while too. You should get two graphs. The first one shows you the distribution, the overall distribution of species range changes. But the most interesting one is certainly the second one. So here we can see how our stratification influences SRC. The black curve is the overall distribution of SRCs. And in the first one, we can see, for instance, that the random forests are predicting greater loss than, for instance, the yellow or the blue one that are respectively GLM or GAM. Interestingly, we can see that the pseudoabsences dataset selected or the cross-validation run has absolutely no difference in the spread of the SRC distribution. In follow-up video, you will be able to see how to do multiple species modeling, but also how to fine-tune BioMod2 with Maya Gegen presentation. And finally, for those of you that want to use BioMod2 within the graphical interface, there will be a video by Yan Ondo on Chinese BioMod. Congratulations and thank you for your attention.